On Sunday morning, December 7, 1941, the Mare Island built USS Ward would sink a Japanese midget submarine outside of Pearl Harbor.
General quarters, all hands man your battle station.
The Ward would flash a warning to the naval base, but on that quiet Sunday morning it would be ignored. An hour and a half later, the Japanese air attack descended on the U.S. fleet.
Yesterday, December 7, 1941, a date which will live in infamy, the United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. American ships have been reported torpedoed on the high seas between San Francisco and Honolulu. Yesterday, the Japanese government also launched an attack against Malaya. Last night, Japanese forces attacked Hong Kong. Last night, Japanese forces attacked Guam. Last night, Japanese forces attacked the Philippine Islands. Last night, the Japanese attacked Wake Island. And this morning, the Japanese attacked Midway Island. With confidence in our armed forces, with the unbounding determination of our people, we will gain the inevitable triumph, so help us God. I ask that the Congress declare that since the unprovoked and dastardly attack by Japan on Sunday, December 7, 1941, a state of war has existed between the United States and the Japanese Empire.
The Japanese attack had succeeded in shocking and uniting the nation for the hardships to come. This was total war, fought and won by the entire economic, industrial, and scientific capabilities of our country. This, then, is the story of the role Mare Island Naval Shipyard played as a critical component of America's arsenal of defense in that great conflict. The USS Olympia is central to America's national story and one of our most endangered historic places. The fact that she could be subject to uncontrolled flooding at any moment due to the condition of her hull should be of concern to all Americans. I urge you to support the effort to save the Olympia, our national historic landmark.